Still a good year. It is still a good year. No matter what has happened, no matter how bad the previous moons have been, this year is still a good year. What is it that you have been through this year? Maybe you lost your job due to the downsizing of your company. Maybe you lost a loved one, a mother, a father, a sibling, a grandparent, or a spouse, to a sickness or an accident or anything else. The Lord says to you today that this is still a good year. What was the word of God for the year in your local church? What did God tell you about this year? What were the wishes you had for this year at the beginning of the year? All those things can still come to pass in your life. You can still do that thing you planned on doing. Did you plan on going back to school and you've been having disappointments upon disappointments in all the schools? Do not give up on that dream now. The year is not over yet. You still can do it. You will get the admission and study. Maybe you had planned on starting up your own business, but when you have the capital to start it, one problem or the other will come and take it away. Or maybe you just are not able to gather the resources necessary for the business to start. It's still a good year. You can still achieve it. You still are gonna be able to start up the business and it will flourish. Maybe you were told at the beginning of the year that this year is gonna be your year of harvest, but in the last month, you haven't seen any harvest at all. Everything you had sown, even tears you had cried, every book you had ever read, all the time and energy you have invested, you don't seem to be yielding fruit. Rather, it's as if you have to work extra hard this year before you can get anything. The Lord has said that this is a good year and His word is final. Whatever He says must come to pass, so be rest assured that what He has said to you is going to come to pass. In Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 3, the Bible says, "For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though we tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry." If God through His servant have said that this year is going to be a good one, it is, because He knows that the time is right for you to get all that He wants to give you. You on your part are not required to just sit around doing nothing. You can't say because you were told that this year is gonna be your best year yet, you're not gonna put in any work. You will just eat and sleep and fold your arms doing nothing and it's gonna come to pass. That's not true. James chapter 2 verse 20 says, "But wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead." Faith without works is dead. You believing in that word that was spoken to you and doing nothing about it is not gonna work for you. You need to work hard too. If you do not go to school, how are you gonna get a degree? To get the money you wanna get, you need to work. The Bible says God blesses the works of our hands. You need to be doing something. You cannot have a bountiful harvest when you did not plant anything. What did you expect to grow? The Bible tells us of the story of Isaac. He dwelled in the land of Gerar, and there was famine in the land. And God said to Isaac, "Remain there and plant that he will have a bountiful harvest." Let's imagine for a minute that Isaac just went and slept, saying God has promised to give him a bountiful harvest, so he doesn't have to do anything. He wouldn't have gotten anything. He might have said God is a liar at the end when he doesn't see any harvest. In Genesis 26 verse 12, "Then Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year 100-fold, and the Lord blessed him." So whatever it is that God has promised you in this year, do your best, work at it, do your part. Let God bless the works of your hands. You may be thinking that it's all over. You may think all hope is lost. Maybe the year is left with only 5 or 6, 4, 2, 3, 1 month, whatever. And you think it's too late to start now. Maybe you think you cannot do it again. Just maybe you think that this year is a bad year for you or your family or in your business or in your relationship. You can make it good. You still can stand. You can act now and change the course of this year. You can start by dissolving relationships that don't support your success. People who do not encourage you to do better. People who keep on belittling you and or your dreams. People who convince you to give up on your dreams and aspirations. Cut them off, no matter who they are. Even if it's your friends or your family, your colleagues, reduce the amount of time that you spend with them while increasing the amount of time you spend with people who support and encourage your dreams and visions and growth. You can turn this year into a great year by learning today from your past mistakes and not repeating them. It's never too late to learn from a mistake that you made in the past. The right thing to do is always the hardest thing to do. You can turn a new leaf now. You can start afresh today. Let go of the past. Start a new chapter of your life. Philippians chapter 3 verse 13 says, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting all those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are ahead." The past is not all that relevant. That's all it is. Past. So let it remain in the past. That's where it belongs. Go out there and learn new skills. Learn a trade. Learn how to bake. Learn how to make pastries. Take time to enjoy every step of your journey. Have fun. Make out time to exercise. Change your perspective about things. Put your goals into writing. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 2 says, "And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon the tables, that he may run that readeth it." Read and meditate on it every day. A wise man once said, "If you think something or someone other than yourself is responsible for your happiness or your success, I'd guess you're not that happy or successful." Take charge of your life. Be happy by yourself. Spend time with yourself. Build new relationships. Connect with people that can make positive additions to your life. Strive to make a balance in your life. You don't want to be successful in some areas of your life and fail at others. Be consistent in your endeavors and you will see that all you plan for this year will come to fulfillment. This year is still a good year. This year is still a blessed year. This year is still your year. You can still achieve that dream. God has said it, believe it, and walk at it.